Oh, we're going.
Hey everyone, this is Jane.
I didn't even know we're going. Let's do it.
Okay, well, we wanted to bring you a mindset little message today because I think we get so caught up in what our brains think that we realize it really, for the most part, has nothing to do with our reality, and our brains can create bad stuff, good stuff.
But, you guys, your brains, if you could just understand how powerful you really are. And I think sometimes we just need permission to know how powerful we are. My daughter, she got her ears pierced recently. Oh my goodness, she's so cute.
She's five
years old. Yeah. And she was the one, she has an older sister who's 8, and she was the one who, like, for sure, I'm getting my ears pierced. And so her older sister got her ears pierced because of the 5-year-old. So cute, but she's just been doting over these earrings and making sure they're pretty and staying in and didn't want to get infection. And she's done amazing. Well, it's been now a while and she's good. She's at the point where she can change her earrings. And one had fallen out. She put it back in by herself. And then I told you that story. So the other day, I don't get to drop them off at school very often, but this day I did. And I don't remember. I think it was just her. No, I dropped them off both. And then I dropped... And I was just leaving, and all of a sudden I heard this, "Dad, Dad!" I'm like, "That sounds like Dad." And it was my daughter, that five years old. She says, "Dad, Dad!" And I said, "Okay, what's going on? It's okay." And I just paused. I rolled down the window, and she said, "Dad, are my earrings gonna be okay?" I said, "Yes, your earrings are gonna be completely fine, and you're gonna be completely fine today. You know, there's no need to fear." And so I was just thinking of that in life. I think too, so often our mindset, and you guys, as soon as I said that, her mindset completely changed and she just went skipping on her way. And I think, what is your mindset in? What is my mindset? Is my mindset, am I afraid of everything? My earrings are going to fall out. My buttons are going to come off. Am I afraid I'm never going to get healthy? And I think that's my biggest kind of message as we're talking today is where is your mindset? And if it is in the sense of fear, let me just say to you this. I give you permission. I give you my doctor authoritative. Things are going to be okay. They always work out.
Yeah.
And it really is a mindset. And if you set your mind to it and start truly creating that sense of, you know what, I'm going to be okay, you will find answers.
Yeah, well, and the thing is, like with your daughter, she just needed reassurance from someone because she's only 5 and you're teaching her how to change her mind because your mind creates your reality.
Right.
So if you have something happen, your mind processes it and continues to process it literally creates the reality of it. So say, for example, something bad happens. Someone cuts you off in traffic and maybe you even wreck. Let's just use that for an example, okay? Yeah. This is a bad thing that just happened. Now, say the cars got wrecked, but nobody got hurt. So what happens, you can spin this into a really horrible thing. You could be mad at the person. You can obsess about it and obsess about it and upset and get angry. Or you can, you know, the accident happens. It is what it is. Sometimes things happen and they are what they are. You can't go back and change it,
right?
Okay? So you can say, you can be thankful that no one got hurt. You can be thankful that, you know, your cars, you probably have insurance. There's all these things that you can be grateful for, but you can take that even for little tiny things like earrings. And how your brain thinks about it is literally what creates your reality. So what I would like to do is just challenge you to, when you have these thoughts that are super, super consuming you, and like I sometimes get so angry, and I'm going to be really vulnerable here, at my husband as something that it literally causes me some anxiety. And what I've learned to do, and I still have to do this. I don't think it ever changes, this being human thing. I still have to go, all right, what do these feelings mean and how are they serving me?
Oh, that's a great line.
Yeah. It's kind of like,
what are these feelings, being aware of your feelings?
Yeah.
And how are they serving you?
Right. And then what I do is I acknowledge them. I say, yes, I'm super angry.
Great.
at
And
this.
that's what I the phrase that I call you got to feel it to heal it. So
Right.
you feel it. Good.
And then what I do is I sit with it for a minute and I give myself permission to be
Good.
super angry. I
She
do.
was gonna say a different word.
I
She didn't feel
was
it.
gonna say the
She
P word, but I can't do
So
that.
she feels it. She feels it to heal it. You're
And
exactly right.
right.
And then what do you do?
Well, and then I go, this does not help me and serve me. And I've now felt those emotions, and I literally in my mind I watch them go away. Like I
Excellent.
let them go. And then what
That's a great
happens?
technique. And your whole time you're breathing,
Oh
and then she
yes.
uses her eyes visualization,
Yep.
and she cognitively she's aware. So she had awareness, breathed it in and out, felt it, filled it. Feel it to heal it, and then this is awesome. Your visualization, that's great.
Yeah, well, and this is what's crazy, because when something happens that made me mad, he usually doesn't even know that it made me mad. Most in relationships and stuff like that, that's usually typical, right? So if I'm able to get a grip on it before I see him the next time, because this has happened in the past where we will connect and I'll just be like, blah. And then it turns into this whole ugly thing where thing and he so recently this happened probably a couple weeks ago, and I had all these this anger and anxiety and all of this, and I'd released it and everything. And then I when I went home later, it was like la la la, like he had no idea that I was even worked up about anything or that he'd even said anything to work me up. So and then I did choose to bring it up, but it was no big deal. I just needed him to be aware that look, this is what you said, and this is how it made me feel. But there was no anger and there was no
Hostility.
hostility, and I was not accusing. I was just like, look, I just need you to know that this you said this way, and
This is how it made
it
you
made me
feel.
feel like this. So I think that this actually turned into something a little more powerful than I was thinking.
It always does.
So I hope this is helpful for you guys. To me, our brains are so powerful to create the life that we want and to
Yes.
create the health that we want. And if we utilize them, we know some of these simple little techniques, they can completely change the terrain of our health and the path our lives go on.
I say this to my children. You can complain or you can create. And so seriously, today create something great. And so with inside of us is the greatest medicine cabinet on planet Earth. Learn to use it and create something great.
Awesome. Thanks, guys. Thanks for tuning in, and we hope you have a great day.